Hello, dear students. My name is Medvedeva Anna Valentinovna. I am assistant professor in the department of Saratov State Medical University. And today I will describe you diseases and cancer of gastrointestinal tract. And at first I want to repeat you normal anatomical structure of gastrointestinal tract and histological picture. In this photo you can see esophagus, part of esophagus and part of stomach. And histological examination, normal histology of esophagus in the left part of slide. What can we see? We see flat epithelium without keratinization. And histological examination of stomach, normal histological picture. Anatomical picture of esophagus and stomach. And at first, I want to describe you aggressive and defense factors of stomach. Which aggressive factors? Those factors can lead to diseases of stomach. At first, it's Helicobacter pylori infection, acid secretion, pepsidin secretion, cigarette smoking, and corticosteroid use. These aggressive factors and defense factors, mucus production, bicarbonate production, mucosal blood flow, and prostaglandins, which stimulate mucus and bicarbonate production and blood flow. And this balance between aggressive and defense factor can lead to diseases of stomach. Which diseases of GIT tract we see more often? Yes. More important diseases of GIT. At first, gastritis, peptic ulcer, appendicitis, and gastric cancer. At first, information about gastritis. What's this gastritis? It's very, very often disease of GIT of stomach. It's inflammatory disease of mucous membrane in the stomach. There are two main forms, acute and chronic. At first, about acute. Which etiological factors of acute gastritis? Maybe exogenous factors and endogenous. Exogenous, irritation of mucous membrane of stomach by sharp, hot, cold food, alcohol, medical preparations, chemical substances, influence of microbes and toxins. What about endogenous factors? Auto-infections, auto-intoxications, neuroendocrine derangement, chronic cardiovascular diseases, and allergical factors. There are four types of acute gastritis. Catarrhal or simple and fibrinous are more favorable types of acute gastritis. And purulent or phlegmonous and necrotic or corrosive are unfavorable. Catarrhal and fibrinous gastritis means catarrhal inflammation, fibrinous, we see appearance of films in the mucous membrane of stomach. Purulent inflammation and necrotic, deep necrosis of the wall of stomach. Which outcomes of acute gastritis? Full restoration due to catarrhal gastritis, we can see full restoration of mucous membrane. This is very favorable, most favorable type of gastritis. Maybe some types of gastritis can lead to chronic gastritis, type B more often. And atrophy of mucous membrane and after deep necrosis, for example, sclerotic deformation after phlegmonous gastritis of stomach wall, and deformation and unfavorable outcome. In this photo, you can see catarrhal gastritis. We see mucus and red color and edema of mucous membrane of stomach. Catarrhal gastritis with hemorrhagic component. It's necrotic gastritis after action of acid or alkali, aggressive type. In this photo, you can see anatomical and histological examination of acute gastritis with edema, with enlarged vessels, and neutrophilic leukocytes infiltration. In this photo, you can see gastritis complex with liver, stomach, and part of duodenum. And we see necrosis in the wall of stomach. Many erosions and ulcers after action of aggressive factors. In this photo, you can see the one outcome of necrotic gastritis, rough sclerosis. What about chronic gastritis? There are three types of chronic gastritis: autoimmune gastritis type A, non-immune gastritis type B, and reflux gastritis type C. What about type A gastritis? Autoimmune. It's a rare form of chronic gastritis, 1% only of all chronic types. A localization fundal zone of stomach. Clinically, with a decreased acid, hypoacid situation secretion, pernicious anemia as a complication, increased risk of gastric carcinoma. And histological type is atrophic type. I will describe histological types later. What about non-immune gastritis type B? This orphan type of chronic gastritis, 70-80% of all chronic types of gastritis, and etiology may be endogenous, but more often exogenous factors, highly spiced food, irregular meals, alcohol intoxication, and localization of this type in enteral part of stomach clinically. Excessive secretion of acid, hyper secretion, and more often histological examination is superficial type. And reflux gastritis type C, which etiology? This gastric resection more often after operation. Localization enteral part and in pathogenesis we see regurgitation of bile acid, alkali secretion, and lyso lectins from the proximal duodenum. I talked about histological type or morphological type of chronic gastritis. We talked about superficial. More often in type B, we see atrophic type can be with metaplasia and without metaplasia. And uncommon forms, esophilic, lymphocytic, hypertrophic gastritis. In this photo, you can see normal gastric mucosa histological examination. In this photo, you can see chronic superficial gastritis. We see growth of connective tissue and infiltration by lymphocytes and plasmocytes. Chronic gastritis with metaplasia, this atrophic type. We see atrophy of epithelial cells of villi in the stomach and metaplasia enteralization, appearance of cells of intestine. And in this photo you can see eosinophilic type, rare type. This atrophic type. And we see metaplasia, appearance of cells, those cells we see in the intestine, enteralization. The next disease, peptic ulcer or peptic ulcer disease. What's this? this chronic disease with cyclic course, and morphologically we see appearance of chronic ulcer in the stomach or duodenum. Localization, stomach and duodenum only. More frequent in patients with alcoholic cirrhosis, chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, and chronic renal failure, we see. And first and more important cause of a peptic ulcer is stress. In the first place is stress. But we see action of Helicobacter pylori and after acute gastritis. We can see appearance of peptic ulcer. In pathogenesis, we see disbalance of hormonal and nerve system is general factors and local factors disbalance between aggressive and defense factors of stomach. In morphogenesis, there are three stages of peptic ulcer. At first, hemorrhagic erosions. In the first stage, we see many superficial defects in the mucous membrane, and this stage is reversible. The next, acute ulcer, deep necrosis, but up to 1 centimeter. And the next, we see chronic ulcer, appearance of connective tissue in the bottom and the edge of ulcer. And the next, we see repeated acute, chronic. The cyclic course. In this photo, you can see many small hemorrhagic erosions and pigment hematin, which grows of peptic ulcer in the stomach. Size variable and 1, 2, 3, 4 centimeters in diameter, maybe. A shape more often oval or round. Localization in the stomach, lesser curvature, pylorus and antrum. In duodenum, bulbus and post-bulbus part. In this photo, you can see acute peptic ulcer. Up to 1 centimeter with irregular edges and necrotic masses in the bottom. In this photo, you can see acute ulcer too. In this photo, you can see X-ray examination with ulcer and histological examination. We see deep defect. Macroscopically, what can we see? Necrotic masses and extraction of necrotic masses and formation of defect. We see infiltration by neutrophilic leukocyte in the acute stage. Due to chronization, we see growth of connective tissue, at first granulation tissue, and formation of rough scarring in the down part of this slate. In this photo, you can see granulation tissue, this not mature, this young connective tissue, and formation of rough scarring. In this photo, you can see chronic ulcer, oval form, large, more than 1 centimeter, and growth of rough connective tissue in the bottom and the edges of ulcer. Chronic ulcer, deep chronic ulcer with connective tissue and deformation of the wall of stomach. Chronic ulcer. There are four groups of complications. First group, destructive form we see due to acute part. What can we see? Growth of ulcer. As a result, we can see perforation with peritonitis. Penetration. What means penetration? It's growth in the organs around stomach and duodenum. For example, maybe penetration to the pancreas with pancreonecrosis, very, very aggressive complication with that outcome and hemorrhages. In the second group, inflammation due to acute phase, we can see acute gastritis around ulcer, phlegmon formation, perforation, duodenitis, periduodenitis. In the next complication group, stenosis, through many years, we see rough sclerosis. As a result, we see deformation of stomach and maybe stenosis of stomach or duodenum. And the last group of complications is malignization, development of cancer. Ulcer, cancer through many years. In this photo, you can see a complication, bleeding, hemorrhage, peritonitis after perforation, deformation, hourglass stomach as a result of rough scarring and deformation. The next disease of GIT, appendicitis. What is appendicitis? It's inflammation of appendix with a special characteristic clinical syndrome. Which etiological factors of appendicitis? Autoinfection, derangement of permeability of appendix, and neurovascular disorders. There are two main groups, acute and chronic. More often we see acute form. There are three main stages of acute appendicitis. At first, we see simple appendicitis. We see only derangement of blood permeability. We see derangement of blood circulation, edema, and without infiltration, leukocyte infiltration. Superficial, the next we see superficial, this local leukocyte infiltration in the wall of appendix. And after one day, we see destructive forms, purulent forms, diffuse purulent form of inflammation. At first, phlegmonosis, the next, apostematose, the next, formation of ulcers, phlegmonosis, ulcerosis, and the next, necrosis, deep necrosis, primary gangrenosis, secondary gangrenosis, and gangrene of appendix. And chronic appendicitis. In this photo, you can see in the left part normal appendix, in the right part inflammation of the appendix, phlegmonosis, appendicitis. In this photo, simple appendicitis, we see derangement of blood circulation only in the serous membrane. In this photo, phlegmonosis, appendicitis, diffuse purulent inflammation with necrotization. Phlegmonosis, appendicitis 2, and in this photo, phlegmonosis, appendicitis. In this photo, we see black color, gangrene of appendix, gangrenosis, appendicitis. After 3-4 days, we can see. In this photo, you can see phlegmonosis, appendicitis, histological examination of phlegmonosis, appendicitis. Phlegmonosis, appendicitis, phlegmonosis, appendicitis. And what about complications of acute appendicitis? Maybe perforation is the ulcer, is a result of ulcer formation. Perforation with peritonitis more often. Autoamputation due to gangrene form. Empyema of appendix due to phlegmonosis form. Periappendicitis, periphlebitis, and abscesses of liver as a result of microbial emboli. What about chronic appendicitis? Which anatomical manifestation of chronic appendicitis? We see atrophy and sclerosis of the wall of appendix, obliteration of the volume of appendix, and edema of appendix. Look, in this photo you can see anatomical picture of edema of chronic appendicitis and edema of the appendicitis. And the last information about cancer of GIT. At first, I want to repeat you what's this differentiation and dysplasia. I repeat you, Displastic cell show. What can we see in displastic cell? Pleomorphism, hyperchromia, and large nuclei. Loss of mitosis, pathological mitosis, and architectural anarchy, abnormal growth of cells. In this photo, you can see normal glands of stomach. And in this photo, mild dysplasia. We see different forms of nuclei, but mild. This normal gland and moderate dysplasia. We see different form, different size of nuclei in the cells, but more serious and severe dysplasia. The serious, these precancerous cells. In this photo, you can see normal squamous epithelium in the esophagus. Moderate dysplasia in the middle side. In the right side, severe dysplasia. See, abnormal cell, abnormal growth. And about cancer, the scheme of non-invasive cancer. Invasive cancer with the growth up to basal membrane. And deep invasion carcinoma. And scheme of metastasis, metastasing carcinoma, transport through blood or lymph flow. In this scheme, you can see premalignant changes in the prismatic epithelium. In the left side, normal prismatic epithelium, the next metaplasia to the flat epithelium, and the next in the right side, dysplasia, abnormal cells. With hyperchromical abnormal polymorphic nuclei and cells. In this photo you can see dysplastic epithelium in the left side and normal squamous epithelium in the right side. And first information about cancer of esophagus. Localization, more often border of the middle and lower third of esophagus. Which premalignant conditions of cancer in the esophagus? Diverticulosis, achalasia, and chronic esophagitis. And premalignant changes in the cells. At first, leukoplakia, keratinization of flat epithelium, and dysplastic changes in the flat epithelium. Which anatomical types of cancer in the esophagus? First, diffuse infiltrating type. Ring shape. It appears as annular stenosing of the lumen due to infiltration into the wall of the esophagus. The next type, polypoid fungating type or papillar. It looks like as a cauliflower, like mass protruding into the lumen. And ulcerating type. It looks like as a necrotic ulcer. What about histological type? At first, carcinoma in situ, non-invasive form of flat epithelium. The next, squamous cell non-keratinization and with keratinization carcinoma. And rare form is adenocarcinoma. In this photo, you can see normal histological structure of esophagus. In the left side, we see normal flat epithelium without keratinization. In the next, we see severe dysplasia and non-invasive carcinoma. Invasive type of cancer, squamous cell carcinoma with invasion. Invasive form of carcinoma with keratinization and adenocarcinoma. Which complications of the cancer of the esophagus? Tracheoesophageal fistula as a result of destruction of cancer. Aspiration pneumonia. Abscess and empyema in the lungs. Mediastinitis is a result of growth of cancer in the mediastinum. Hemorrhage, bleeding, and cancer cachexia. The next information about gastric cancer. Which premalignant conditions of gastric cancer? adenoma or polyps, adenomatous polyps of stomach, chronic atrophic gastritis, pernicious anemia as a result of chronic atrophic gastritis, and chronic ulcer, which premalignant changes in the cells and in the cells of glands of the stomach. Metaplasia, for example, we see, I told you, we can see appearance of cells of intestine with metaplasia and dysplastic changes in the epithelium. Look, in this photo you can see cancer is the ulcer. Microscopically, which types of microscopically gastric cancer? Cancer with exophytic growth in the volume of stomach, cancer with endophytic growth in the wall of stomach, and cancer with exo and endophytic growth mixed. With exophytic growth, as a plague shaped, as a polyp, polypoid, as a mushroom, fungos, and ulcerated types, primary ulcerose, saucer shaped or cancer ulcer, secondary destruction of cancer known, and ulcer cancer. At first with a chronic ulcer, the next malignization of ulcer. With endophytic growth, there are two types of endophytic form, diffuse and infiltrative ulcerose. In this slide, you can see several photos of anatomical changes due to adenocarcinoma cancer. Different types. As an ulcer, cancer as an ulcer, as a plaque, and deformation of stomach due to cancer. As a polyp, histologically, more often we see adenocarcinoma. The next in the second place, undifferentiated, with low differentiation, medullary, solid, sclerose, signet, ring cell carcinoma. And rare form, adenosquamous cancer. In this photo, you can see precancerous changes, intestinal metaplasia, several intestinal metaplasia. This several dysplasia and formation of cancer, which metastasizing, which spread of stomach also, or stomach cancer. Through lymph flow, is regional, affected of regional lymph node, and distant, orthograde and retrograde forms. Hematogenous in the liver, in the lungs, and by implantation in the surrounding organs. Look, this Virchow's metastasis in the subclavian lymph node, this retrograde spreading. And in this we see growth of adenocarcinoma of the stomach into pancreas, in the surrounding tissue. The next type of cancer, colon cancer. Which premalignant conditions? Chronic ulcerocolitis and polyposis, familial polyposis, many polyps in the colon. Which premalignant changes in the cells? Dysplasia. In this photo, you can see familial polyposis of large intestine, this obligatory precancerous condition. Polyposis, this polyps, histological examination, polyp. Histological, anatomical and histological examination, large colon polyp, histological examination. Which anatomical forms of cancer in the large intestine. As a polyp, polypose, massive form, as an ulcer, ulcerose, and diffuse growth. In this photo, you can see polypose form of cancer. Which histological forms? More often, we see appearance of adenocarcinoma. The next, renal cell, undifferentiated form. Renal cell carcinoma, maybe squamous in the zone of anus. And undifferentiated forms, other undifferentiated histological forms. Which complications? Bleeding, hemorrhages as a result of destruction of cancer node. Paraproctitis, peritonitis after ulceration and perforation. Cancer cachexia and obstruction of the volume of intestine and stenosis. That's all. Thank you for your attention.